Back home near Cardiff, the festival fun is over and it's back to work. Kai and the architects are here with drawings.
You obviously need a new staircase.
Yes.
One thing I've been trying to do is to get the sort of the biggest, grandest, widest stair from the ground floor.
Yeah.
Coming up to a really generous 1.3 metre wide landing so that you could have window seats on the landing. And we can either look at the stained glass that's there already, or you could change it to clear glass there so you can have views out.
That's what I'd like
from those window seats.
Yeah. There is part of me that would love that that's just all open space.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how that works, and I can't really envision it in my mind, but somewhere in my mind I was thinking about big tree or something.
Mm-hmm.
Again, I don't know how. But that, yeah, if those stairs came back a little bit, that you'd be able to see, you know, all three floors or two floors up.
You might be able to get a planter.
Oh, yes.
In between the basement stair and the window.
Yes.
So, might work. You might not get a tree in, but you never know.
It's very fluid at the moment, which is, on one hand, it's nice. I like that. She is very creative. She likes to get everything together, every option on the table, and then sort of, you know, work her way through it. And she comes up with good ideas. She's got a good mind for it and a good eye for it all, which I like. And it's quite nice working with her. But yeah, there's definitely going to come a point where there's a line in the sand where we're like, we need to finalise things for definite, you know?
So above that, on the floors above, I would really, really like to try and keep the original stair for all kinds of reasons, apart from the fact that it's a really beautiful bit of joinery. It's going to be quite expensive to rip it out.
I don't know.
I think there are so many things you could do to the stair before taking it out. You could paint the stairs.
Yeah.
Is it the kind of darkness of the timber?
It's the darkness of the timber, it's the panels, it's the mismatch in the woods.
Mm-hmm. Right.
The obstruction of the windows.
And the obstruction of the windows.
Right.
So, you know, it's just that clearly that massive bank of windows has been put in after the staircase, so it just doesn't make any sense.
See, I'm not sure I completely agree, because if the stair from the ground floor is this very wide, grand thing that feels like it's like the floor going up, the ground floor stair like belongs to the ground floor, and then when you go up into the first and second floor, you've got this different stair. You know, I think that's okay.
Andrew's the third person to keep on at me about those stairs. Maybe I'll just put in a fireman's pole.
I totally accept your concerns about all kinds of elements, but I'm still pretty sure that there's a solution.
Okay, so although seeing some plans has been super exciting, there's still loads to decide before we can show final ones to planning. The renovation isn't the only thing I've got going on. I have another project that means a lot to me.
I'm also running a democratic creative school in Cardiff, which is an education charity, and we've got a board of trustees, and, you know, so that's really gaining momentum. So it's really busy.
No, we helped, guys. That was really good.
The learning community is called the Awen Project, and I run it with my husband, Johnny.
Excellent.
The school has kind of taken over my life in some ways, which I'm actually quite grateful for, considering the pandemic. You know, all the rest of the work stopped.
It's a privilege to work in this environment, and it's brought us together.
I think that we have spent the last 5 years being incredibly close and much, much better at communicating. We've worked together forever in bands with the school project. So it's almost like we're really quite well practiced at this juncture of A, being in each other's pockets, B, being really stressed together, but also being really stressed together in amongst other people.
Do we want a fire today?
The school is a massive part of my life. I set it up like 2 years ago, and it's a lot of work. It's loads of work, but it's amazing, you know? So it's worth it.
Awen runs 3 days a week, and has an emphasis on exploration, nature and creativity, whilst also learning more traditional subjects.
Strike it down here. Watch, and then get it straight in there.
Whilst I oversee the Radal Dog renovation, Johnny will be in charge of running the learning community without me, which he's absolutely brilliant at.
It's been good to have something to just completely focus my energies on. But yeah, I've been subsumed by it completely. I never intended to be in the classroom at all. And then I sort of became an accidental educator.
I am digging through trash in order to make a sign that says Trash Monsters, because these guys have got their Trash Monster exhibition. So it's really cool. Essentially, it's a multifaceted project, which is about understanding our use of resources.
And so how are you shaping the head?
He's also going to have a lower jaw wall. But I'm not sure I'm going to connect it to the tree yet, but why not
we? I think the handy thing with the chicken wire is that it attaches to itself really well, right?
Yeah.
So you could maybe wrap a layer of chicken wire around the tree. Cool. It's looking good, though. Like in your arms.
Thank you.
With my own kids, I could see that the mainstream school system was okay for some, not optimum, and just frankly terrible for others.
It's quite wet, so it's not sticky.
So I just started looking into alternative education, and it's been a real journey for a number of years since my kids were little. And there's been things we've tried which haven't worked at all. But I think really at the heart of it all was this idea of children's rights. And because they make their own rules and they are therefore self-governing. And so in a way, it's more hardcore than if a teacher were to go, you've broken the rules, you can't do this, detention for you. Because you've got to, as kids, you've got to hold each other accountable.
I just need to make sure that this doesn't move. I don't want it to fall, because last time it nearly fell off the head because I didn't put enough tape on it.
If only the rubbish we keep finding in Radal Dog was as useful as the trash we found in our school.
There is mice there, but I just see one.
Me and my dad are at the foot of the forest with our mate Scott, staring at the eyesore left by the previous owner who bought the house from the Ashleys, and I'm tamping.
What was basically the house that he knocked down and put by ear? So, fuming. It's really, really terrible. It's a terrible thing to do. Even just for the environment, it's got to come out, Yeah. Like, it's just a real piss take. I don't know why anybody would do it. To save money, I imagine.
This dump has been terrible for the surrounding nature, and in 10 years, nothing has grown here, so it's got to go, even if it takes weeks to clear.
It ruins it when you take it all down. Oh, think of the scenery, think what you're going to be able to see from standing here.
Yeah.
It's costing me £10,000 to clear up this mess, money I could have used on so many other things. But Kai has called in a digger driver. The lovely Wynn.
He actually knocked down the back end of the house, and what was in the old house, I believe, basically dumped here, so he's probably dug all new footings and all the demolition from the house. And we're trying to dig down so we can get back to the existing forest floor and get rid of all this junk. We got about 1,000 tonnes worth of building waste to get rid of.
It's not ideal, really. Everything's in it. It's full of metal, plastic, and stuff really that shouldn't have just been dumped here,
Fuming. Thankfully, having Dada on site helps to calm things down.
In part, he's worried about it, but only a tiny bit of him, because, he's been living with a terminal illness, essentially, for the last 5 years. So whilst I think he's like, oh gosh, that's a big mortgage, you sure? That's crazy, it's crazy. It's crazy you bought this crazy house, Sha. What have you got that for? But I think he's totally behind me, and we've got the best relationship. He's so lush, I love him to bits.